There was a moment, not too long ago, when the most advanced technology in my classroom was the overhead projector. It hummed and whirred like a relic from a bygone era. Fast forward to today, and we're discussing whether my next history tutor might be an AI. It's a fascinating pivot, isn't it? From fearing the day that robots would take our jobs, to debating whether they should be responsible for our education. Artificial intelligence is the hottest topic on the news in all spheres of our life. But have you ever wondered how AI might transform schools and shape the future of education? Could generative AI be the key to unlocking unlimited learning possibilities? I'm here today to review AI and its influence on education. According to a report by Research and Markets, it is predicted that the global AI and education market size would reach $10.9 billion by 2026, growing at a progressive annual growth rate of 39.3% from 2021 to 2026. This statistic not only highlights the technological revolution, but sets the stage for a profound transformation in educational practices. But let's take a step back and understand how generative AI, this incredible force, is not just reshaping the fabric of our industries, but reweaving the very essence of our learning environments. Back in the 1980s, Benjamin Bloom graphed out his data and created the Two Sigma problem. This problem stated that the best solution for teaching kids is one-on-one tutoring. But why would this be a problem? That's because there was no way to pay so many tutors. Fast forward 40 years, and we have AI to do the job. But what is generative AI? Well, generative AI, in simple terms, is AI that can think like a human. And in some cases, even better. So what has been the recent buzz about AI? Recently, AI has transformed many fields, and education is no exception. For example, I remember sitting at my kitchen table, struggling with my Python code that did not run. After about an hour, I was getting desperate when curiosity unexpectedly took hold of me and made me wonder if ChatGPT could actually figure it out. To my astonishment, the AI succeeded. Not only did it solve my coding challenge, it even clarified the concept. Learning Python has transformed for me, as now the explanation to a concept is at my grasp whenever I need it. And the new AI mentor is available to me 24/7. Now let's delve into some more key challenges that can be addressed or mitigated through the application of generative AI. First, we have the one-size-fits-all approach. Consider the traditional classroom setup. A teacher at the front, students arrayed before them, all eyes on the chalkboard. This model, centuries old, is fundamentally the one-size-fits-all. Yet, we live in an era of personalization. From news feeds to music recommendations and For You pages, why should our education remain static? The uniform curriculum may not cater to the diverse learning needs and preferences of individual students. Generative AI, on the other hand, can help personalize learning experiences by adapting pace, content, and teaching methodologies to better suit each student's strengths, weaknesses, and learning style. Furthermore, it would help better accommodate for students with special needs, such as learning disabilities and language barriers, to ensure they have the support they need in order to succeed. AI integrated with assistive technologies can aid students with autism, dyslexia, ADHD, etc. With features like text-to-speech, interactive activities, and interactive simulations, and more. Amos Miller, a blind engineer, created Glidance, a robot that would effectively regain the independence of blind people. Glidance is a robot that would essentially act like a guide dog, locating doors, getting into elevators, avoiding obstacles, etc. Next, we have accessibility. Many schools, particularly in underserved communities, struggle with limited access to quality educational resources. One example of an underserved community is Nageshpur, my grandparents' village in India. In Nageshpur, there is always a shortage of resources and teachers. Generative AI can help bridge this gap by creating digital learning materials, generating interactive simulations, and even offering virtual mentoring services. And feedback? Generative AI makes it a two-way street. It gives instant feedback on assignments, allowing students to better understand concepts. Instant feedback is an amazing way to improve students' learning abilities, building off of their original piece. Lastly, it can help ease teachers' workloads by assisting teachers with automating routine tasks, such as grading assessments, generating lesson plans, and offering feedback. Generative AI can help free up teachers' schedules, allowing them to make more personalized interactions and lessons when teaching their students. But just think about it. Every interaction a student has made with educational material, every quiz taken, every assignment completed, generates valuable data. But what if we could find a way to harness this data in a meaningful way, not just to track progress, but to truly understand how each student learns best? That's where generative AI comes in. With its ability to process vast amounts of data and identify patterns, generative AI can help understand students to help them learn better. It goes beyond mere assessment by providing deep insights into a student's strengths, weaknesses, and preferences. The AI uses machine learning and comparison to review a student's work. But it's not just about reactive measures. Generative AI can help predict what students might need before they even know it. By spotting trends across various students, we can design lessons that work for everyone's learning style. But we need to be careful. As we use generative AI to teach our students, we must do it ethically. We need rules to keep students' information safe, and we must only use it to help them learn better. I believe the key to stopping plagiarism and cheating is AI with boundaries. One example is Salcon's tutor company, Khan Academy, which has 137 million users to this day. As a user myself, it really is a great tutor. However, Sal has implemented KhanMigo, an AI which is not perfect, but is a very good representation of AI with boundaries. It's like a tutor sitting right by your side, ready to help you when needed. And it completely blocks the idea of plagiarism and cheating by analyzing the student's response. Now, many still believe that we can't overcome this mountain of change. However, we already have before. To understand, let's go back in time to 1988, where many teachers protested against the use of calculators. They said how calculators were going to lower students' grades and more students would cheat. As you know, that's not the case. By working around the barriers, we were able to dodge an obstacle in a safe educational manner. A similar phenomenon occurred in 1998 with the creation of Google. However, instead of protesting, we once again worked around the barriers and we were able to create a supportive learning tool. If we can get past some relatively controversial setbacks in the past, what's stopping us now? Finally, as we wrap up our talk, we can conclude that AI can play a crucial role in paving a pathway towards a more personalized, dynamic, and inclusive learning environment that caters to the diverse needs of students, to promote equity, fairness, and student well-being. So as we envision the future of our schools, let's embrace generative AI as a tool for positive change. But let's also remain vigilant in making sure that it leads us towards a transformative educational landscape that benefits all learners. Thank you.